Now we'll multiply radicals that contain variables. In general, to multiply radicals, the index must be the same. Then we multiply the coefficients. And then we multiply the numbers underneath the radicals, or the radicands. And the last step is to simplify this product. So here we have the square root of 18x cubed times the square root of 30x squared. While we could try to simplify before we multiply, we would still have to check to see if the product would simplify again. So to only have to simplify once, we'll first multiply these square roots and then simplify once. So this is going to be equal to the square root of 18x cubed times 30x squared. And now instead of finding this product, we'll actually find the prime factorization in this form to identify all the perfect square factors that will simplify. So 18 is going to be equal to 2 times 9, and 9 is equal to 3 times 3. So we have a factor of 2 and two factors of 3. And then for 30, we'd have 3 times 10, 3 is prime, and 10 is equal to 2 times 5. So the product would contain all of these prime factors. So we'll have the square root of 1, 2 factors of 2, 1, 2, 3 factors of 3, and a factor of 5. Now let's look at the factors of x. We have 3 factors of x here and 2 factors of x here, which would be x to the fifth. But because we have a square root and we're looking for perfect square factors, write x to the fifth as x to the second times x to the second times x. The x to the seconds would be perfect squares. And now to simplify this, we'll circle groups of two equal factors because those would be the perfect square factors. Here, 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 and here. So the circled factors will simplify, and the factors not circled will not simplify. So we'll have a factor of 2, a factor of 3, a factor of x from this group and this group. So we have 2 factors of x outside the square root, and we're still left with 3 times 5 times x underneath the square root, which would be 15x. So we have 6x squared times the square root of 15x. Now remember, if the index is even and the exponent on a variable is odd, we need an absolute value, but because we have x raised to an even power, we don't in this case. Now we have the cube root of 16x squared times the cube root of 81x squared. So again, instead of simplifying first, we'll simplify after we multiply. So this is going to be equal to the cube root of 16x to the second times 81x to the second. And now instead of finding this product, we'll find the prime factorization in this form. So 16 is equal to 4 times 4, and 4 is equal to 2 times 2. So we have 4 factors of 2. And for 81, we have 9 times 9, and 9 is 3 times 3. So we also have 4 factors of 3. So this is going to be equal to the cube root. We'll have 4 factors of 2, 4 factors of 3. Now let's look at the factors of x. We have x to the second times x to the second, that would be x to the fourth. But because we're looking for groups of 3 equal factors to match the index, we'll write this as x to the third times x. It's still x to the fourth, but here's a perfect cube factor. And now we'll circle groups of 3 equal factors. Here's a perfect cube factor, as well as here and here. So we'll have a factor of 2 and a factor of 3 outside the radical, as well as a factor of x. And then we're left with the cube root of 2 times 3 times x, which is 6x. So we have 6x outside the cube root times the cube root of 6x. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.